Hi students, how are you? I hope all are fine. Grade 7 Science Chapter 2 Force and Motion. In this lesson, we are going to see the distance and displacement, importance of force and motions, etc. Let's see, children. So, topic of the lesson is force and motion. In this lesson, we are going to learn distance and displacement. So, this distance is the total length of path taken by an object to reach one place from the other is called distance. Displacement is the shortest distance from the initial to the final position of the object. Next, you see the diagram here. First part is take the 10 kilometer. Second part takes 7 kilometer. And the third part takes 5 kilometer. So, from these three parts, first part 1 and part 2 are the example for distance and part 3 is the example for displacement. This diagram represents three parts. First part take 10 kilometer, second part takes 7 kilometer, third part takes 5 kilometer. Part 1 and 2 distance, part 3 is displacement. You see this diagrammatic representation. Rabbit starts from A and reaches the point B. Okay. To find the distance and displacement, you count the squares here. The distance is 17 meter and the displacement is straight line. So, displacement is 3 meter. So, when will the distance and displacement be equal? If the rabbit is moving in a straight line, path from the starting to finishing point, then the distance and the displacement will be equal. So, answer the following questions. First question, Subhas goes to nearby playground from her home. So, what is the distance she travelled? So, see one diagram is given in this book. Subhas traveling to 400 meter path and reaches the playground. This is Subhas' home and this is the playground. So, she is traveling to 400 meter path and reaches the playground. The distance she traveled is 400 meter. The displacement. So, what is her displacement? The displacement is 100 meter. Next question. The distance traveled by an object is 15 kilometer and its displacement is 15 kilometer. What do you infer from this? So, answer is, if the distance traveled by an object is 15 kilometer, displacement is also 15 kilometer. So, both are equal. So, the object travel in a straight line. Third question, the distance of the person is 30 kilometer and his displacement is 0 kilometer. What do you infer from this? The answer of the third question is the starting point and finishing point are equal. So, the starting point and finishing point are equal. Okay, children. Next, nautical mile. The nautical mile is the unit for the measuring distance in the field of aviation of sea transportation. One nautical mile is 1.852 kilometer. So, the unit for measuring the speed of aeroplanes and ship is knot. Okay. Next is speed and velocity. So, speed. Speed is the rate of change of distance. So, speed is equal to distance by time. Next, the unit is meter per second, m per s. So, the speed is classified into two types. One is uniform speed, another one is non-uniform speed. If a body is moving, covers equal distance in equal interval of time, and then the body is said to be uniform speed. And non-uniform speed means if your body covers unequal distance is equal interval of time, the body is said to be a non-uniform speed. So, average speed equal to total distance traveled by time taken to travel the distance. Next one, velocity. Velocity means rate of change of displacement. So, velocity V equal to displacement by time. So unit SI unit of velocity is meter per second. One sum is given in your book. If an athlete in the diagram takes 20, see one diagram is given in your book. If the athlete in the diagram takes 25 seconds to complete the 200 meter sprint event, find her speed and velocity. So speed is equal to distance by time. So 200 divided by 25 is equal to 8. So 200 meter and 25 is second. So 8 meter per second. Velocity of equal to displacement by time. So 50 divided by 25 is equal to 2 meter per second. So velocity again divided into two types, uniform velocity and non-uniform velocity. So uniform velocity means a body has uniform velocity if it covers equal displacement in the same direction is equal intervals of time. Example, light travels through the vacuum. And non-uniform velocity means if either speed of directions changes, the velocity in non-uniform. Example for this non-uniform velocity, a train starting and moving out of the station. Next, average velocity equal to total displacement by total time taken. So you see this triangle, what do you infer? DVT. D represents displacement, V represents velocity, T represents time. To find the displacement, it is represented here. For example, velocity means displacement divided by time. So time equal to distance, to find the time means displacement divided by velocity. So to find the displacement C equal to velocity into time. Okay. Next, answer the following questions. First question, calculate the velocity of the car traveling with a uniform velocity covering 100 meter distance in 4 seconds. So, page number 20. Answer the following questions. Calculate the velocity of car traveling in the uniform velocity covering 100 meter distance in 4 seconds. So displacement is 100 meter. So time is 4 seconds. So the velocity equal to displacement by time. So 100 meter per 4 second. So 25 meter per second. Next one. Second question. Usain Bolt covers 100 meter distance in 9.58 seconds. Calculate his speed. Who will be the winner if Usain Bolt competes with the cheetah running at a speed of 30 meter per second. So second question answer, speed equal to distance traveled by time. So 100 meter divided by 9.58 seconds is equal to 10.44 meter per second. The speed of Usain Bolt equal to 10.44 meter per second and the speed of cheetah is 30 meter per second. The cheetah will be the winner. So, page number 20, third question, answer the following question, third one, you are walking along east covering a distance of 4 meter, then 2 meter towards south, then 4 meter towards west and at last 2 meter towards north and you cover the total distance in 21 seconds. What is your average speed and average velocity? Answer for this question. No, north to east is 4 meter and east to south 2 meter and south to west 4 meter and west to north 2 meter. So the total distance traveled 12 meter. So time is equal to 21 seconds. So average speed equal to distance traveled by distance traveled by time is equal to 12 by 21 is equal to 0.57 meter per second. Okay, next one, average velocity is equal to displacement by time. So 0 by 21 seconds is equal to 0. Okay, the total distance traveled 12 meter, time is equal to 21 seconds. So average speed is equal to distance traveled by time. So distance traveled 12 divide by 21 equal to 0.57 meter per second. And average velocity is equal to displacement by time. So, 0, displacement is 0 by 21 second is equal to 0. So, here the starting point and the ending point are same. So, the displacement is 0. Next one, acceleration. So, acceleration small a. Acceleration is the rate of change in velocity. So, acceleration equal to change in velocity per time. Final velocity v minus initial velocity u divided by time t. So, a is equal to v minus u by t. So, SI unit of the acceleration is meter per second squared. Here, page number 20. In your book, the velocity of at different times of a train departing direction is given in your figure. Analyze and with this complete the table kuduthirukanga. So, first one, the distance travelled by the train A to B. So, A vandu 0 seconds and A reaches B in 10 seconds at 6 meter per second. So, the initial velocity meter per second u equal to 0 and final velocity 6 meter and change in velocity v minus u. So, v is 6 minus 0 is equal to 6. Time taken t by second in seconds 10 seconds. So, acceleration change in the velocity per time is equal to a equal to v minus u by t. So, a is equal to v minus u by t. So, 20 for example, v equal to 0 minus u, v equal to 6 minus 0 by how many seconds? Time taken 10 seconds. So, 6 by 10 equal to 0.6. Okay. You have to complete, you have to find the answer for this table column. Okay, children. So, positive acceleration means if the velocity of an object increase with respect to time, then the object is said to be in positive acceleration or just acceleration. Negative acceleration or declaration or retardation. Abdina, if the velocity of the object decreases with respect to time, then the object is said to be the negative acceleration. Okay. Next, uniform acceleration means an object undergoes a uniform acceleration when the change in its velocity for every unit of the time is same. Non-uniform acceleration, the velocity of every unit of time is not same. Okay. Next one, center of gravity. The center of gravity of an object is the point through which is the center, with the entire weight of the object appears to act. Generally the center of the gravity of the geometrical shaped object lie on the geometric center of the object. Next, weight of the chord, weight of the triangle, weight of disc, weight of ring. These are all example for the center of the gravity for regular objects. Next one, stability. So, stability is the measure of the body's ability to maintain its original position. There are three types of stabilities are there. Stable equilibrium, unstable equilibrium, neutral equilibrium. So, stable equilibrium means when the change of an object, when we change the object's position, it's come back to its original position and the center of the gravity remains the same. It is called stable equilibrium. Next one, unstable equilibrium. When we change an object position, it does not come back to the original position and the center of the gravity or changes. It is called unstable equilibrium. Next one, neutral equilibrium. When we change an object position, it comes back to the original position when the change the object position, it does not come to back the original position and the center of the gravity remains the same. It is called neutral equilibrium. Okay, next, real life application of a center of the gravity. Yeah, it is for the reasons of stability, that is the luggage compartment of the tour bus is located at the bottom and not at the roof. Extra passengers are not allowed at the upper deck of the crowded double-decker bus, and racing cars are built low the broad of stability. The table lamps and fans are designed with large heavy bases to make them stable. Okay, children. Thank you.
Definition of distance and displacement, differentiation between distance and displacement, speed and velocity, calculate the speed of moving objects. Okay, children, you read the lesson. We will see in the next video. Thank you.